All on board for our daily encounter.
Hello, World Changer. These are your captains speaking. We are here at Mercy Command to ensure that you are readying your spaceship as we encounter God today.
That's right, World Changer. God wants to reveal a mystery to you today. Prepare for launch. This encounter is going to be wild.
It's going to be out of this world. We are going to explore various lands and meet new friends as they encounter God with us, as we seek His heart and learn His ways. Ready, Captain?
Ready. Ready, World Changer?
Prepare for launch. Let's pray. Holy Spirit, we welcome you here. We ask for you to teach us your ways, that we would know you and find your favor. Amen.
Amen.
World Changer, get ready for takeoff. 5, I am a child of God, full of His Holy Spirit. 4, I am learning His ways. 3, I am made to encounter Him daily and know Him more. 2, I am walking in His favor and carry His presence wherever I go. 1, I am a world changer.
Hello, World Changers. Captain Emily here, coming to you from Mission Control. Here at Mission Control, it is our directive to prepare you for the mission God has for you. Today, we are going to continue our training and encounter God together. World Changers, your mission, if you choose to accept it, is to join Andor and the Space Guardians to learn how to remain strong in the power of the Lord to fight dark forces. If you're going to succeed in the mission God has for you, you must know how to withstand evil. But first, let's pray and invite the Holy Spirit into this time. Holy Spirit, we give you our minds, our hearts, and our attention. You're welcome into this time to teach us more about you. We ask that you speak, Lord. Your servants are listening. Amen. Now it's time to find out what our revelation for the week is. A revelation is when God's truth is made easy to understand. So let's see what it is. Okay, our revelation this week is, God's word is my defense. Well, Changers, let's say a revelation together. Repeat after me. God's word is my defense. Great job. Now let's go over to Yarnold, our data operator, for our memory verse.
Thank you, Captain Emily. Hi, everyone, it's Yarnold, the data and information archival overseer aboard Mission Control. Did you know that each loop in Fruit Loop cereal tastes exactly the same? It's a conspiracy. Why are they all different colors if they taste the same? It's outrageous.
Absolutely crazy back there, Yarnold, but the World Changers need to hear the memory verse.
Oh, that's right, sorry. I'm a little crazy over here. Okay, it's important to memorize scripture because it is the word of God. So say this after me. Be strong in the Lord and in His great power. Wear the full armor of God so you can stand against the devil. Ephesians 6, 10 through 11. Incredible job! Super! Now I need to get back to my cereal tasting test. I'm revealing the lies! Stay vigilant!
Well, thank you, Yarnold. Well, Changers, I'm so glad you're with us. Let's begin today's mission.
When you walk into the room, everything changes. Darkness starts to tremble at the light that you bring. And when you walk into the room, every heart starts burning. And nothing matters more than just to sit here at your feet and worship you. We worship you. We love We want you. Come and consume God. All we are. Give you permission. Our hearts are yours. We want you. We want you.
Last time on Space Guardians, I retrieved the Helmet of Salvation with my friend Buttons the Bounty Hunter. Then Z-Bub showed up with the shield protecting his ship. He demanded that I give him the helmet and I was like, no. Then we fought it out. I was totally winning, but then he cheated. Blobby escaped, but myself and the ship blew up. So now I'm floating in space toward a desert planet while Susanna, Blobby, and Roger work to get the shield back from Z-Bub. We only have one more piece of the armor of Velion left to find. Let's go.
We have a lock on Z-Bub's ship. Tell me, how is the probability of a successful teleportation?
73%.
That will have to work. Roger, are you ready?
Yeah, for Andor.
Right, hold still and prepare for teleportation in 3, 2, 1.
I made it.
Hurry, Roger! You need to find the shield and replace it!
Yeah, Roger, do it! Roger got the shield!
Shh! You don't want to alert anyone.
Hello.
No!
Who are you? Did Thebop recruit you recently?
I Toby.
Oh, nice to meet you, Toby. What are you doing on the command deck?
Come on, Roger.
I hit to make repairs on warp stabilizer.
Oh, yep. That's been giving us some trouble for some time now. Well, you get to it. Thebop has me on bathroom duty today. It's a mess in there, let me tell you.
Oh, that's a close one. Goodbye, Toy. I will miss you. I will miss you so much, Toy. Hello, Shell!
Okay, Susanna, teleport me back!
You did it, Roger! You got the shield!
Yeah, I got the shield! Roger!
Let's tell Blobby and the commander the good news and head towards Andor's last location.
Yeah!
Commander! Nigel! I can't get a signal. I have no communications, no navigation. Commander always says that the most powerful weapons that a space guardian has are prayer and the word of God. Holy Spirit, I need you to show me how to get out of here. You created the entire universe. You know every inch of it. Show me where to go.
All right, Space Guardians. We've made it to the last known location of the Gamma Laser Thunderwolf. Keep your eyes peeled for Andor.
Blah, blah. I look everywhere for him.
Had to be a desert planet. Bunch of sand dunes. And I am 300% sure I've seen that sand dune before. I've got sand in my shoes, sand everywhere. And I hate sand. I just have to stay positive. There's power in the word of God. And Psalm 91 says that God is my refuge and that he will rescue me. And I believe your promise. What is that?
In the wreckage. Tammy!
Yes?
Please run a thermal scan for life in the wreckage.
The weather for today appears to be negative 455 degrees with a slight chance of solar flares.
No! Demi! Please run a thermal scan for signs of life.
Yes, scanning now.
Thank goodness.
Zero heat signatures, no life detected.
No! No, this can't be. Andor is dead!
I feel so alive! I am awesome! Oh, yeah.
He was so awesome!
I have to admit, I had a feeling we would find him. I can't believe he's gone. Tammy!
Yes?
Call the commander.
Yes.
Susanna, what news do you have?
We're on location, Commander, but we didn't find any sign of Andor.
He dead. There's no hope.
No, we're not giving up. That's not what we do. We're finishers like Jesus. We're going to keep looking for Andor, and we're going to find the last piece of the armor of Elian.
Commander, I have calculated the location of the last piece of armor.
Fantastic, Eve. Where is it?
According to my calculations, the Sword of the Spirit is located in the quadrant that Susanna is currently stationed in.
What? We're close to sword?
A sword? But, Commander, a sword is not a piece of armor. I think Eve might have a screw loose or something.
Blah, blah.
Even though it's not technically armor that we wear, it still protects us. It's also very important because it fights off the enemy. The Sword of the Spirit is the Word of God. His word is the only truth, and it's how we know what God's perfect will is. That is why we can depend on it to defend us no matter what the circumstance.
But how can we depend on words? They're just words, right? Turtleneck, cookie dough, platypus.
I don't mean words like that. The word of God holds power when we speak it, when we read it, and when we hear it. In fact, let's listen to this file about a time when Jesus used the word of God to defend against the enemy. Eve, play file 4.1-11.
Playing file now. After Jesus was baptized, the Holy Spirit led him into the desert to be tempted by the devil. He was alone for 40 days. Jesus was fasting, so he did not eat. He was very hungry, thirsty, and weak. It wasn't long before the devil came to tempt him. The enemy recognized his physical weakness, but Jesus was spiritually strong. The devil offered Jesus some wonderful things, but Jesus wasn't fooled, not even for a second. The devil knew that Jesus was hungry, so he said, "If you are the Son of God, tell these rocks to become bread." But Jesus wouldn't do it. Instead, he replied, "The scriptures say that bread is not enough. People need more than food to live. Their lives depend on whatever God says." The devil took Jesus to Jerusalem and put him on the edge of a high place near the temple. He whispered, "If you are the Son of God, jump off. The scriptures say that God will command his angels to catch you." But Jesus knew this was another trick. He answered from God's word again. "The scriptures also say, you must not test the Lord." Finally, the devil tempted Jesus by offering to make him great. He led Jesus to the top of a very high mountain. He showed Jesus all the wonderful things in the world. The devil said, "I will make you king over all of these places. I will give it to you if only you will worship me." Jesus said to him, "Get away from me, Satan. The scriptures say you must worship the Lord your God and serve only him." So the devil gave up tempting Jesus. Jesus had simply told the devil the truth from God's word. When you are tempted, God's word is your defense too.
You see the power of God's word? It is so powerful. The enemy can't stand against it and has to flee.
But, Commander, the devil told Jesus what the word of God says. How does the enemy know what the Bible says?
The enemy is tricky. The devil loves to twist the truth and lie to us and make something evil actually appear good. He will always disguise his evil plans as something we might wish for, but it will always lead to destruction.
Man, I could go for a globulin berry soda right now. Commander. Commander. Commander, can you read me?
Hello, Andor Starwin.
Zebub.
I thought I destroyed you. How is this possible?
I told you, a space guardian will always fight for good.
Keith, beam me down.
Oh, and I found this.
You are indeed a powerful foe, but you've been out here for quite some time. I have refreshments and a nice place for you to rest aboard my ship if you will join me in my conquest for the universe.
Forget it, Zebub. I'll never join you.
Think about your friends, Blarbo and the Commander. You know they stand no chance against me. Join me and I will spare them. They can even have a place in my army.
None of us will ever abandon our fight for good and righteousness.
Ah, yes, your fight. How about this? If you will serve me, I will give you many galaxies. You will be able to rule over them how you see fit. The Space Guardians will be an unstoppable force. Everyone will know your names. Isn't that what you want?
No. The Bible says in Romans 12:21, not to be overcome by evil, but overcome evil with good.
Ah, you forget. I hold the... What is this?
Looks like Roger pranked you pretty good.
Keith, this is your fault!
It's over, Zebub.
Keith, beam me up! Beam me up!
Might still be stranded on this planet, but at least I did the right thing.
Good morning, sir.
Nigel! Nigel, you're back!
Indeed I am, sir. The solar flares off and it charged my systems.
They did it, Nigel. They got the shield back from Zebub.
Huzzah, sir.
We gotta get the helmet and the sword back to Commander.
I will put out a distress signal right away, sir.
Thank you.
My pleasure.
Commander, we have just received a distress signal.
Where's it coming from?
I've tracked it to planet T26. The signal is from Nigel. Susanna and Roger are still nearby.
We'll put them through, quick!
Yes, Commander!
We just received a distress call from Nigel. Andor must be alive on planet T26. Hurry!
Blah, blah, blah!
He alive? I knew he alive the whole time!
Tammy, set a course for the signal. We're on our way, Commander.
When you walk into the room, everything changes. Darkness starts to tremble at the light that you bring. And when you walk into the room, every heart starts burning, and nothing matters more than just to sit here at your feet and worship you. We worship you. Starts to vanish, every hope hopeless situation ceases to exist. And when you walk into the room, the dead begin to rise, 'cause there's resurrection light in all you do. Permission, our hearts are yours. We want you, we want you. Come and consume, God, all we are. We give you permission, our hearts are yours. We want you, we want you. Come and consume, God.
Ship here, but boy, am I glad to see you guys.
What? We're glad to see you too, Andor.
Congratulations, Guardians. You've all done exceptionally well standing strong against the enemy.
Commander, incoming transmission from Zebub.
Put it through, Eve.
You meddling space guardians! How dare you! You've done the inconceivable!
Oh no! I'm trying to stabilize the booster, sir, but
Keith,
it's not working!
This is all your fault! You're the one who flew us into a dying star!
Well, I thought you said fly the Death Star over there!
I said fly the Dead Star out there! That's the name of our ship, the Dead Star!
I'm so confused! I don't do well under pressure, sir.
Ugh. I will find a way to get my revenge upon you, space guardians. If I have to cross through thousands of worlds and dimensions, I will. You've not seen the last of me!
No, they haven't. We'll see you later, guys.
Well, I don't think we're gonna be hearing from him anytime soon.
What? Warping through a black hole in a dying star is not something I wish to do.
I think Zebub is done for now. But we shouldn't let our guard down. Now that we have all of the pieces of the armor of Elion, we must train all our space guardians and cadets on how to use them. Sun, Susanna, Blobby, Roger, you've all done well. Return to base. Oh, Andor.
Yeah?
I had the engineering team manufacture another starship for you, identical to the Gamma Laser Thunderwolf in every way.
You did? That's awesome! Thanks, Dad!
Blah, 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 blah.
You're welcome. Now head on back. You've all earned some rest.
What? Tammy, engage hyperdrive!
Hang on, everyone.
Wow, what an incredible adventure we had with the Space Guardians. We saw that God's word is our sword against the enemy. We combat Satan's lies and attacks with scripture. The Bible says that when we resist the devil, he will flee. When the enemy comes around and tries to tempt us or lie to us, we have to speak the word of God, and its power will strike the enemy. If you want to have that kind of power, the power that only Jesus can give us, and you haven't made him the king of your life, it is so easy. Just say this out loud after me. Jesus, I'm sorry for the sin in my life. Thank you for coming to earth and dying for me. I believe you rose to life again. I believe you are the one true living God. Come into my heart and make me new. I give you my life. Be my king. I love you, Jesus. Amen. If you prayed that prayer and meant it, then Jesus is your king and your best friend, and the power of the word of God is yours to use. The more time you spend talking to Jesus and reading and hearing the Bible, the more your power will grow. Remember, world changers, to put on the full armor of God every single day in your daily encounters. This is how you will remain strong in the power of the Lord to fight dark forces. This is how you will succeed in the mission God has given you. Until next time, over and out.